Hello everyone. Today we'll be covering how to move edge and move vertex in Format. We'll begin with a few shapes to demonstrate these actions. So let's start with moving an edge. I'm going to be rotating the view a lot during this video, and I'm doing so by holding down the right mouse button and moving my mouse around. I will also be zooming in and out using the scroll wheel on my mouse. Scrolling away from me zooms in and towards me zooms out. So you can see if I select this edge with one click, it highlights blue. Click on it again to move it, and it will stretch and manipulate the faces attached to it. It is best to utilize shift locking once you find your correct axis to not distort your shape unintentionally. So once I start moving along the blue axis, I will hold down shift and move until I get to an 8-foot dimension, and click once to accept the location and escape to let go of the edge. You can correct an edge that is out of alignment by also using the move edge tool. This shape has one off-axis side, and I want to move this edge to fix it. So when selecting an edge, you do need to choose where on the edge you will move it from. So click once to select the edge, and as you can see, all of my familiar snaps are lighting up. The large green circle shows that I'm on an edge, the red square endpoint, and the red triangle midpoint. Since I have a shape sitting on the ground plane, it may be best to move this edge by that endpoint. And let me show you why. If I select the midpoint of the edge and move it, it starts to want to snap to the ground plane and facets begin to appear on the top face, meaning we are no longer moving this in an aligned direction. So let's escape once to let go and click again on the ground plane endpoint of this edge and see how much easier it is to move about with confidence in your alignment. Now pay attention to the purple inferences that I've highlighted. Since we have an angled face, it automatically gives us these guides to stay parallel or perpendicular to the angled face. In this case, I want to get back to the alignment, so I will shift lock on the red axis and remote snap to the adjacent corner to lock in my edge. In the next shape, you'll notice another edge out of alignment, so let's grab that edge by clicking once, selecting an endpoint, shift locking on the green axis, and remote snapping to the vertex we want to align to. Now let's try moving a vertex. This shape has lines on the top face to help create a hip roof by moving the vertices vertically. When hovering over a vertex, you'll see a new symbol, a blue circle with a gray transparent fill indicating a vertex. Click once and select, and again on the endpoint, snap and move up. You should easily find the blue axis and shift lock to make sure you are on it. Now let go of the shift and start typing in a dimension in the tool options dialog. Press enter to accept, and escape to let go of the vertex. As we go to the next vertex, you can see that the first vertex move created facets to the top face. Select the next vertex and repeat the process along the blue Z axis with the same dimension as the first. You'll notice that the facets have left lines on the faces, so if you want, you can now edit the separated faces by selecting them and dragging them, but since these facets share the same plane, you can delete the edge that separates them to join the faces together. So select each facet edge with one click and delete. And that's it for Format Move Edge and Move Vertex. Be sure to check out more videos on the Format YouTube channel.